Hello guys, I am Shreya and I welcome you all to my channel Knowledge Info. Today in this video, I will discuss with you all about a very important topic which proved to be a powerful weapon for Indian citizens. In this video, I will discuss about Right to Information Act 2005. Yes, in this video, I will discuss its features, its objectives, its rules, how to apply for it and important sections of it and lots more. So watch the video till the end in order to gain proper information. So without wasting any more time, let's move towards our video. RTI. It stands for Right to Information Act. Now we will discuss what is the meaning of RTI. The Right to Information was enacted on 22nd June 2005 and it came into force or commenced on 12th October 2005. This law empowers Indian citizens to seek any accessible information from a public authority and makes the government and its functionaries more accountable and responsible. Right to Information Act 2005 mandates timely response to citizen requests for government information. Right to Information empowers every citizen to seek any information from the government, inspect any government documents and seek certified photocopies thereof. Now we will discuss what are the salient features or provisions or objectives of RTI. We will discuss it in points. Let's begin. First point, to set out a practical regime of right to information. Second point, to secure access to information under the control of public authorities. Third point, to promote transparency and accountability in the working of every public authority. Fourth point, to constitute the central and the state information commissions. Fifth point, to contain corruption and to hold government and its instrumentalities accountable to the governed. Sixth point, to preserve the confidentiality of sensitive information. Seventh point, to uphold the democratic ideals with an informed citizenry and transparency of information. Out of all those objectives we discussed before, the main aim of RTI is to provide clarity of information to its citizens, to contain corruption and to promote accountability in the working of every public authority, and also to grant freedom to its citizens in order to seek information from the government. Now we will discuss some of the important rules of RTI Act 2005. First point is Section 1 Subsection 2 says that this act applies throughout India. One thing important to notice, previously this act extends to the whole of India except Jammu and Kashmir, but now it is enforceable to the newly created Union Territory after the removal of Section 370 and 35A. Second point is, for the enforcement of RTI, government established Central Information Commission constituted under Subsection 1 of Section 12 and State Information Commission under Subsection 1 of Section 15. Third point is, a fixed time of 30 days is given to provide information. One thing important to notice, under Section 7 Subsection 1, if the information is concerned with the life and liberty of a person, in that case, information shall be provided within 48 hours of the receipt of the request. Fourth point, under Section 2 Subsection F, information can be demanded in any form, may it be in the form of records, documents, emails, opinions, advices, press releases, circulars, logbooks, contracts, reports, papers, diskettes, floppies, tapes, video cassettes, or in any other electronic mode, or through printouts where such information is stored in a computer or in any other device. Now I will tell you about the departments covered under RTI Act from which you can demand and get the information. First point, government hospitals. Second, government schools and colleges. Third, public sector undertakings, which is known as PSUs. Fourth point, non-government organizations receiving funds from government. Fifth point, government insurance companies. Sixth point, president, governor, chief minister, etc. That is all government officers. Seventh point, government banks and all government offices. Eighth point is election commission. Now we will discuss about the departments which are not covered under RTI Act. One of the important section in this category is Section 24, Subsection 1 of the Central Act, which goes on to limit RTI coverage by entirely excluding some bodies from the law, such as security and intelligence organizations, may it be established by central government or state government. Some intelligence and security organizations which come under second schedule established by central government are Intelligence Bureau, Border Security Force, Central Reserve Police Force, National Security Guards, Central Economic Intelligence Bureau, etc. Now we will discuss a very important topic, that the RTI filed by you can be rejected on what grounds. It can be rejected under Section 8, Subsection 1 and Section 9. First point is, Central Public Information Officer or State Public Information Officer can reject the receipt of request if the information demanded affects the sovereignty and integrity of India, the security, strategic, scientific or economic interest of the country. Second point is, it can be rejected if the information demanded leads to disclosure of information related to India's relation with foreign country or lead to incitement of an offence. Incitement means to provoke. Third point is, under Section 9, Central Public Information Officer or State Public Information Officer may reject a request for information which would involve an infringement of copyright of any private sector. Infringement means to violate or to breach. Now we will discuss about the steps you need to follow for filing RTI. Step 1. Identify the department you want the information from. Step 2. Write down the application by hand or type it in English or Hindi or the official language of your area. Step 3. Write down the name and address of the office from which you want to seek the information. Clearly mention seeking information under the RTI Act 2005 in your subject line. Step 4. State your request in the form of detailed questions. Step 5. Pay rupees 10 to file the plea. One thing important to notice, applicants below the poverty line or the BPL category need not to make the payment but have to attach a copy of the BPL certificate along with the application. Step 6. Provide your full name and address, contact details, email address and sign the application clearly. Put in the date and the name of your town. Step 7. Send your application by post or hand it in personally to the department concerned. Don't forget to get an acknowledgement. The law mandates that information be provided within 30 days. Now we will discuss some of the important sections of RTI Act 2005. Section 1, Subsection 2 says that it extends to the whole of India, including the Union Territory of Jammu and Kashmir. Section 3. It says that it is applicable only for Indian citizens, that is, only they have the right to seek information. Section 6, Subsection 1. It describes the way of writing the application. Section 6, Subsection 2. It says that the applicant need not to provide any reason for requesting the information or any personal details except those that may be necessary for contacting him or her. Section 6, Subsection 3. It says that if the application is held by another public authority, then that authority shall transfer the application to appropriate authority within 5 days from the date of receipt of the application and inform the applicant immediately about such transfer. Section 7, Subsection 5. It says that no fees will be charged from the persons who are of below poverty line or of BPL category as may be determined by the appropriate government. Section 7, Subsection 6. It says that if the public authority fails to provide information within the time period of 30 days specified in Section 7, Subsection 1, then the information will be provided without charging any fees. Section 8, Subsection 1. It describes the grounds on which information will not be provided if demanded by Indian citizens. It means information which affects the sovereignty and integrity of India. Section 9. It describes that information will not be provided if it involves an infringement of copyright of any private sector. Section 19, subsection 1. It says that if information is not provided within 30 days or if he is aggrieved by a decision, he refers to the applicant of central PIU or state PIU, then in that case the applicant can make the first appeal. Section 19, subsection 3. It says that if you don't receive the information even after first appeal, then you can make the second appeal after 90 days. Section 20, subsection 1. It says that if Central Information Commission or the State Information Commission at the time of deciding any complaint or appeal is of the opinion that Central PIU or the State PIU without any reasonable cause refused to receive an application for information or given incorrect and misleading information, then Central Information Commission or the State Information Commission shall impose a penalty of Rs. 250 each day till application is received or information is furnished. So, however, the total amount of penalty shall not exceed Rs. 25,000. Now, I will tell you the procedure for applying RTI online. First, you need to enter the website rtionline.gov.in. After that, this kind of interface will emerge in front of you. Then, you need to select the department you want the information from. Suppose I want information from Department of School Education and Literacy. Then I will select the public authority, suppose CBSE. After that, you need to enter your personal details, your name, gender, address, PIN code, country, state, status, educational status, whether you are literate or illiterate. Then you need to enter your mobile number, your email ID, and you need to enter your citizenship. It should be Indian. It is applicable only for Indian citizens. Now you need to select whether you belong to BPL category or not. If you belong to BPL category, select yes. Here you need to enter the text for RTI request application. Suppose I want to ask two questions. What are the norms of Central Board of Secondary Education? And my second question is, how much salary are primary teachers paid? You can also attach the supporting document to up to 1 MB in PDF format, but it is totally optional, you can avoid it also. Now I will enter the security code. And I will press to make payment. Now this kind of page will emerge in front of you. You can just pay from credit or debit card or RuPay card, and you can click on pay. You can also pay using internet banking. Now you need to enter your card number, expiry date, cardholder's name, your CVV code, and type the characters. Then you need to tap on pay button and you will get a reference number for future reference. And the information will be provided within 30 days of your request. If not, then you can make an appeal. If you want to file RTI offline, for that I provided RTI application forms in the description box given below. It is available in PDF formats. You can get it downloaded directly from there. It is available in both English and Hindi languages. So with this, we end up with our video. If you faced any problem with my voice, please do forgive me because I'm suffering from cold. So that's what I prepared for you. If you have any suggestions regarding my video, do let me know in the comment box section. If you liked my efforts which I tried to pour in this video, do like, share and subscribe my channel. Don't forget to press the bell icon parallel to the subscribe button in order to get notified when I will upload my further videos. So it's the time to leave now. So until we meet again, stay home, stay safe, do take care of yourselves, do take care of your families, and there's a goodbye. Thanks for watching.